Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, dear GTC participants, from wherever you're watching this great event. My name is Michael Keckeisen. I'm responsible for high performance controllers at ZF Group, and I'm very happy and excited to be here today to tell you a little bit about how supercomputing is changing the automotive industry and will lead to next generation mobility. Not in the future, but now. I'm not telling you anything new when I say that we are in one of the biggest transformation processes of the last decades. The structures, thinking, and business models that worked 2 or 3 years ago will have undergone huge transformations by the end of this decade. We move from combustion engines to electric drives, from driver to driven, from hardware components to intelligent software and hardware systems. Our vision at ZF is to drive vehicle intelligence as a leading technology provider to the mobility industry. And we will do this across all vehicle segments as well as industry applications. And this basically begins with the architecture of a vehicle. The markets are increasingly moving in the direction of dedicated architectures, driven primarily by the concept of software-defined vehicles that offer more comfort and functionality. All manufacturers and suppliers are working on such solutions. What does this mean exactly? Currently, you see it here behind me, we have a huge amount of electronic control units in vehicles. Sometimes we talk about high double or even triple digit numbers of ECUs and lots of cables, so that the various ECUs of the electrical and electronic components can communicate with each other. That's actually not very efficient. So for new and future vehicles, the goal is to design their EE architecture to be as lean and efficient as possible. For example, by reducing the number of ECUs. Fewer controllers also mean fewer cables. That means less complexity and, correspondingly, lower costs. At the same time, the functional architecture is changing. Features are no longer as tightly coupled to dedicated ECUs. This means that when we talk about software-defined vehicles, we should also think about the optimal environment for software. The more efficient and simple an architecture is designed, the better software functions can be implemented, integrated, and orchestrated across the vehicle, and later updated or even expanded in terms of functionality via connectivity to cloud services. To achieve this, it requires smart actuators, intelligent sensors, and, above all, high-performance controllers that take over lots of the tasks previously performed by the many small decentralized controllers. Only then we will be able to switch from a signal-based to a service-oriented architecture. In the future, we will see fewer but much more powerful controllers in vehicles, which will then, depending on the architecture design, be the hubs for features of the domains in the vehicle. With domains, we mean topic complexes such as vehicle motion control, driver assistance systems, and so on. The routing of sensor signals and smart actuators will be bundled by zone controllers, which serve dedicated physical zones in the car as well as low-level controls. This is necessary so the software can work in such an integrated way with the hardware to enable all the convenient features you see here. Altogether, this is supercomputing par excellence. And that's why we at ZF have developed nothing other but one of the most flexible, scalable, and powerful high-performance controllers in the automotive industry over the past few years, our ZF Pro AI. It's a source of vehicle intelligence, AI capable, suitable for different vehicle platforms, EE architectures, and software applications. Pro AI can host domain and also central functions and supports all automation levels from ADAS to AD, from level 2 to level 4. It fits to the needs of high performance computing. It's an all-purpose device and yet more powerful than ever before. By the way, when we presented our first generation Pro AI at CES in 2017, no one had ZF on their radar for high performance computing. Today, we use it in our autonomous shuttles and have several contracts with major OEMs. we are already in the middle of industrialization with the start of production in 2024. In order to make the new ProAI available across all platforms, we paid particular attention to three things during its development: standardization, flexibility, and scalability. This simplifies the choice immensely when selecting ZF ProAI as a high-performance controller for a vehicle. No matter what the application needs are, we have the ideal solution. Thanks to its modular design, ZF ProAI can be equipped with different system-on-chips depending on the planned application and the computing power required. We can install SoCs from different manufacturers and with a wide range of performance levels. The choice here is up to the customer's needs. But we wouldn't be here at the GTC if we couldn't also say that we have worked closely with our partner NVIDIA on the ProAI for 5 years now and have already integrated various NVIDIA chips and GPUs on our boards. Xavier, Orion, and next will be Atlan. And of course, we rely on standardized interfaces, especially high-performance communication interfaces based on Ethernet, starting with 100 megabit up to 10 gigabit. This enables high-performance computing across multiple HPCs by exchanging data with ultra-high bandwidth. Depending on the necessary performance and the thermal vehicle integration concept, HPCs need to take care of high-tech thermal solutions. We see three major cooling options: passive cooling for applications with a low range of functions, or also low-cost solutions; air cooling for easy integration purpose; and liquid cooling for high performance usage. But no matter which cooling system is used, the overall dimensions remain the same, as well as the thermal interface to the board and the main components. Compared to our previous models, the current series of ProAI has a uniform and compact housing size of only about 24 by 14 by 5 centimeters. And at the heart of ProAI is its incredible range of performance. Depending on the planned application, the functions, and the necessary performance required for this, a single unit of the ProAI can achieve a computing power of up to 250 teraops. 250 teraops, that's 250 trillion calculation steps per second, comparable to the performance of 15 to 20 current high-end smartphones, and an increase of 66% compared to the previous model, the ZF ProAI RoboThink, which is equipped with the former SoC generation. Thanks to its scalability, we can also network several ProAIs with each other, so that we currently have a total performance of up to 1,000 teraops, enough to analyze even complex traffic situations in autonomous driving, and enough to process data streams from internal and external sensors, cloud-based input, and vehicle-to-X communication literally in time. In addition, networked system solutions based on the ZF Cloud Connect vehicles with the Internet of Things, and thus, for example, also with our customer applications, such as payment systems for additional vehicle functions or similar. Our connectivity solution is called ProConnect and works perfectly balanced with the ProAI, for example. And while performance increases by up to 66%, power consumption drops even more. With 1 watt of power, the ProAI achieves a performance of approximately 3 TOPS. That's up to 70% less power consumption than before. Here we see a continuous journey of the SoC designs. Typically, every 3 to 4 years, there's a relevant performance increase, and at the same time, power consumption decreases. This is based on the continuous evolution of the silicon process nodes. By the way, as an automotive-grade product, the high-tech interior of ZF ProAI is, of course, resilient and reliable, even under harsh conditions, such as large temperature fluctuations, dust, sand, water, etc. So, that's the ProAI hardware. Let me also talk briefly about our software approach. At ZF, we place great emphasis on open systems that allow our customers to adjust components according to their needs. That is why the design and architecture of the new version of ZF Pro AI is, of course, based on this open and modular approach. The board can operate ZF's own application and safety software, or that of other developers or third-party suppliers. This is possible by our software framework, which is compliant to standards on the market like POSIX conform operation systems, AUTOSAR and AUTOSAR adaptive implementations to support standardization. That's of course important when it comes to bundling cross-vehicle functions in different zones or domains and integrating them into one system. Here we support our customers with our open approach in order to achieve outstanding results quickly. Because in the end, it's about safety. Functional safety is absolutely crucial for high-performance controllers, as they are the control unit, literally. If we think about autonomous shuttles controlling the vehicle. So in the background, you can see our autonomous shuttles. And of course, these systems have to be 100% reliant all times to help guarantee the safety of the passengers and all road users. The same demand for maximum safety already applies to driver assistance functions, such as adaptive cruise control or lane keeping. And ZF has been an expert in such ADAS functions for many years. By using dedicated safety mechanisms for compute, interfaces, and architecture, we can enable our controllers to reach highest safety standard levels. This is enabled by implementing safety features in hardware, software, as well as capable engineering processes that are designed to conform to the highest safety levels. And when we talk about safety, we must, of course, not forget security in view of digitalization and cloud-based applications. Pro AI offers an ASIL-D computing performance and at the same time state-of-the-art protection against cyber threats, which we have to manage over the whole product lifecycle. This includes organizational topics like development processes, standards, and legal requirements. It continues with the necessary security in the production and delivery of the products, like key management, backend connections, for example. And it ends, of course, with the security of the vehicle interfaces, secure in-vehicle communication, transport layer security, ECU access control, secure flash, secure boot, and so on. As you can see, we use a multi-layered approach to make our products not only safe, but also secure. To sum it up, supercomputing is crucial for the next generations of vehicles, and it is already changing the automotive industry today. One goal, of course, is to further improve the mobility experience and offer even more convenience with new functions. And to achieve this, we need those new EE architectures because the mobility experience of the future is defined by functions implemented in software. Importantly, we are increasing comfort and safety with automated driving functions that would not have been possible just a few years ago due to the lack of computing power. Our Pro AI can make an important contribution here as a high-performance controller in future vehicles, from simple control tasks to driver assistance functions in partially automated level 2 and level 3 systems. For example, in combination with NVIDIA Drive to fully autonomous vehicles. Let's shape the future of mobility now. Thanks for your attention. And let's conclude by taking another quick look at the highlights of Pro AI in a short video. See you soon.